Welcome to Rainbow Network Media. Please kindly subscribe to this channel for interesting news. Thank you all for listening. Security operatives in Kenya who huddled the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, to an undisclosed apartment confessed to him that they were sent by the Nigerian government to adopt him. Sahara Report learned that the Kenya operatives chained Kanu to the floor for 6 days, not knowing who he was until the news about him began to filter in. According to the report, it was told that Kanu, by that time, had suffered injuries in his neck and his wrist. Sahara Report gathered that Kanu, for the first time, was interviewed on Wednesday by the Department of the State Service officials in Abuja in the presence of his lawyer, led by Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor. It was during the interview that the revelations of what happened to Kanu in Kenya came out. Kanu was interviewed by DSS agents today on Wednesday in the presence of his lawyers. He had injuries on his neck and wrist from torture. They said they didn't know who he was. They chained him to the floor for 6 days, but they became nice to him once they find out who he was, Barrister Aloy Ejiofor revealed. According to the report that was heard on July 7th, reported that Kanu told his lawyer Ejiofor that he was mercilessly beaten and tortured in the East African country before his extradition to Nigeria. Ejiofor had confirmed the words of Kanu during an interview, adding that Kanu told him how he was detained, not in the Kenya official detention centers, but in a private residence for about 8 days before his extradition to Nigeria. The IPOB leader's lawyer, Ejiofor, had revealed this in an interview, noting that the Kenya authorities would be dragged to the International Criminal Court to offer for the brutality. The lawyer had said there was a clear collaboration between the Kenya government and the Nigerian government, and I am happy that they are now denying the fact that Kanu was arrested in there. But by the time we finish with them at the International Criminal Court, they will never remain the same. He was arrested at the airport there and was taken to an unknown residence. He was subjected to inhuman treatment. Kanu was tortured, maltreated, and mercilessly beaten, as confirmed by him to us. After suspending 8 days in their illegal custody, they now beckon to the Nigerian government. Kanu was lifeless and unconscious by the time they were bringing him to Nigeria. To tell you the level of their conspiracy and the desperation to get him, they brought him here on a Sunday, and the federal government is fully aware that I am his legal counsel. He was brought into the country and inflicted with several injuries, and he is having a number of medical issues today. It was at the beach of the federal government that Kenya was doing those things. This is against all international laws. We are going to address an international court at that level. So guys, the lawyer of Nnamdi Kanu said that Kenya operatives chained Kanu to the floor for 6 days for not knowing who he was until the news about him began to filter. So guys, let's know your thoughts concerning this news. how Nigerian government has asked the Kenya government to adopt Nnamdi Kanu. The operative told Nnamdi Kanu it was learned that he was chained down on the floor for 6 days. Please drop your comments concerning this news and please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more updates. Thank you all for listening.